Greetings. I've talked about the Arab Spring and how it would result in a caliphate. To watch the video, click below, or open the video with the title Current World Events Unfolding Before Our Eyes. For roughly a year now, the U.S. has funded and supplied a group of rebels in Syria. Now a group of rebels in Syria has changed directions and the name by which they call themselves. They called themselves ISIS, meaning the Islamic State of Iraq and Syria. Well, now the terrorists have changed the name to the Islamic State, or Caliphate. This from Al Jazeera. Sunni rebels declare new Islamic caliphate. Notice this last paragraph. I'll make it larger in the next slide. The legality of all emirates, groups, states, and organizations becomes null by the expansion of the caliph's authority and the arrival of its troops to their areas. Basically, this means when our terrorist troops get to your country, you need to surrender and submit. Listen to your caliph and obey him. Support your state, which grows every day. Your adds a nice Mohammedan inclusiveness. This demoniac seriously thinks he has the right to command all Mohammedans on earth. Okay, to be fair, it's not unlike the Pope claiming to be the sole authority of Christianity in the earth. The difference being there is no Christian goal to kill all non-Christians if they will not convert. Here's another news story. ISIL declares victory by establishing new caliphate. So these Mohammedans are hoping to declare the Islamic caliphate in the earth. You may ask, why would anyone want to make such a claim? A caliphate is an Islamic state led by a supreme religious and political leader known as a caliph, or successor to Muhammad. The succession of Muslim empires that have existed in the Muslim world are usually described as caliphates. It is a teaching of Islam that if a caliphate exists, every Mohammedan on earth is obligated to fight for it. It was an early method for Muhammad to command his followers to fight and die for Mohammedism. Now, is this the caliphate I said would be formed? Honestly, I was thinking of a smoother political process. But this is an entirely plausible mechanism to start the caliphate. To be fair, I have no basis for thinking it might be smooth. Perhaps I thought deception would make it smooth, unnoticed. But seeing the current anti-Christian leadership in America, they have no need to hide their agenda at this point. The obiches in the media lie daily to cover the agenda. For example, the IRS scandal is swept under the rug by the media. If Nixon was impeached for 14 minutes of tape, shouldn't IRS minions go to jail for 7 destroyed hard disks of government documents? But that is a different video, and it damns the Republicans for complicity. Back to noticing the caliphate. An interesting wrinkle I see right now is that this month is Ramadan. Ramadan. It is the month of nightly food orgies. It is the month where Muhammad would strategize, edit, and reorganize his Quran each year, and plan how to next attack his enemies, the pagans. So I expect that the new caliphate will follow Muhammad's example. They will lay low during Ramadan and burst forth with new murderous violence right after the holy food orgy ends. Don't be surprised if the media downplays the new caliphate. Notice how the girls kidnapped and enslaved by Mohammedans have disappeared from the news. Did you notice there was, is, not one Mohammedan voice speaking out against this? It's time you opened your eyes to see just how fast events are happening. The worldwide persecution and murder of Christians and Jews is nearly constant. Pray for the Christian brothers and sisters around the world, being murdered and raped and kidnapped and compelled by Satan's religion of peace, just like the Bible said would happen in the last days. Recognize it or not, we are in 'em. But that does not mean the tribulation has started. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.